for a new video. This is the RPG show NC001-S, and this is their kinky curly glueless full lace wig, which has three combs in the front as well as the adjustable strap in the back nape area. This wig is one of their newest colors. This is what they consider an ombre. I will say that it's not really an ombre to me. I'm going to go ahead and use my Coastal Scents camouflage concealer palette just to make my part look a lot more realistic, and I like to place the concealer on the inner side opposed to just having it sit on top of the actual outside of the cap. I do like to braid my wig or my hair actually really tight and just have my braids laying flush to my head, so that way my wig can lay flush to my head. Some of the products that I'm going to be using in this video, I will post them down below in the description box, so in case you guys are interested you can check that out, and some of them I probably won't even be using. Now this is my natural part, and I've already went ahead and made a part in the actual wig once I've washed it and conditioned it. I think it's really important to make sure that your natural part and your wig part are lined up together. That will allow a better wig application, as well as your wig will just look so realistic. I'm going to take my leave out that you see me unbraid and place it inside of my cap. I did unbraid it, and I'm placing it inside because I want to go ahead and lay my unit down. I want it to look flawless, but I want to lay it down flat, and once I'm ready to take out my leave out, which you'll see me doing right here, I'll then pull as much as needed. So when I take out my leave out in this unit, I only use a little bit. I don't use actually all of it. I only use what's needed, and I'm going to go ahead and part that. This unit is 18 inches and it's not a silky texture, and it's not really a coarse texture, but it is kind of in between. This is a great unit if you love natural hairstyles. You can actually do a lot of different pinups with this and they'll look a lot more realistic than just a straight silky straight texture. As well as that, it's a really easy wig to manipulate and blend. I went ahead and sprayed some moisturizer in my frontal area, and I'm going to use my concealer on my own natural part just to make sure that it blends in well with the actual wig unit. You know, I don't want you to be able to tell where hairline meets wig line. So pressing and just rubbing in that concealer, I'm going to be using the back of my comb, and to give my hair a little bit of lift and also to make it a lot more neater, I'm going to be using my hairspray and just my comb or the end of my comb to allow the wig to lay flat. I love my hair to be big and just full, so with this curly unit it does allow you to have very full hair. So I'm going to go ahead and fluff it out. I like the way that they did add the color in the front area as opposed to not being all throughout the entire wig. Like I said, it gives the wig a lot of dimension and just gives it a lot of flavor and style. Now RPG Show does have a lot of new units on their website for the spring, so I would highly suggest checking them out. Now to just give this wig some moisturizer, I didn't layer it, which I probably will. I went ahead and added one of my favorite products, which is Dark and Lovely. The colors are beautiful. It's a very spring and natural hairstyle, and I'll post their information for this unit below. You can always check out RPGshow.com for your new units, and as well all the products will be listed below. Thanks for staying tuned and coming and checking out this video, and stay diva and divalicious, and I'll check y'all in my next video. This is for my babies.